you've gathered round today. I'm Miss Charlotte, and we're back once again to share some music with you. All of the musicians that you saw this season have come back today, and they'll be playing together, including Mr. Hugh, our trusty accompanist, every instrument's partner. He will see how he works together with us today. So we're glad he's here, and we're glad all of the musicians are back. What were the instruments and the people you saw in the concerts before today? I think it might have been Miss Juliette Kang on violin. Mr. Ernie Tovar on horn. Mr. Socrates Villegas on clarinet. That reminds me of a story. Oh, okay, I have to keep going. Mr. Don Liuzzi on percussion. Oh, what a great splash to end with. Now you've heard each instrument all by itself. Now they're going to play together. So we're going to start with something that you can help us on. We're going to be playing and singing a little song. You may recognize the melody. I've just changed the words a little bit. So you know this song is Old MacDonald Had a Farm. We're going to sing together the words maestro, which is another word for conductor. Maestro MacDonald had an orchestra, tra-la-la-la-la. And in his orchestra he had, and each musician will take a turn and you can play along. So are you ready? I think we're ready, Mr. Hugh. Here we go. Maestro MacDonald had an orchestra, tra-la-la-la-la. And in his orchestra he had violins, tra-la-la-la-la. You ready to play? Maestro MacDonald had an orchestra, tra-la-la-la-la. And in his orchestra he had some horns, tra-la-la-la-la. You ready to blow? Once upon a time, there was a man who made red hats. Every morning, he put on his favorite hat for everyone to see and filled his wagon with hats to sell as he walked from town to town, yelling, "Bright red hats! Special sale today!" And he always wore his own so everyone would notice and want one. The hat maker had a favorite tree that he walked by every day. It was a giant tree with hundreds of branches, and it stood right on the edge of a big forest. The hat maker always smiled and said hello to his tree, like he was seeing an old friend. One summer day, it was so hot the man couldn't keep walking in the scorching sunlight and sat down by the tree to cool off under its leafy branches. It felt so good to lean back against the tree in the shade that he closed his eyes and took a nap. Now this was a giant tree right on the edge of a forest, and there was a wagon full of bright red hats, just like the sleeping man was wearing. You won't believe what happened while he was asleep. Sleeping, a very cute little monkey ran out of the woods towards the tree and saw the red hats in the wagon. Then he saw the man wearing a red hat. And you know what monkeys do. That monkey grabbed a hat from the wagon, put it on his head, just like the man. Climbed up the tree to hide. Well, monkeys don't just imitate people, they imitate other monkeys too. Soon, a second cute little monkey copied the first one, grabbing a hat and scampering up the tree. And then a third monkey took one, and then a fourth. Soon there was a whole tree full of monkeys all wearing bright red hats. The man had walked a long time pushing a big wagon on a hot day and was fast asleep. And then he started snoring. Can you guess what happened next? When the man started snoring, all the monkeys copied him. Imagine what a tree full of snoring monkeys would sound like. Well, all those monkeys made so much noise, the man woke up. First, he saw that all the hats were missing. And then he noticed the monkeys up in the tree teasing him and wearing the hats. He shook his fist at the monkeys three times and said, "Give those back!" But all they did was shake their cute little fist three times right back at him. Then the man's heart started pounding as he got angry. He shook both fists three times, yelling, "Throw those down!" The monkeys just copied the man, shaking their fists three times, making him even more mad. He jumped up and down, yelling, "Give back my hat!" And you know, that didn't work either. The man became so furious that he threw down his own hat on the ground in anger. As soon as he threw his hat down, all the monkeys copied him. Hundreds of bright red hats sailed down from that tree. Those monkeys didn't steal the hats. They were just copying the man. As soon as he gave up trying, all the hats came back to him. He gathered the hats into his wagon, thanked the monkeys, who, of course, thanked him back. Thank you so much for joining us today. We had a great time, and I hope you did too. We're so glad you came to us today. It's wonderful whenever we can share this way. You'll always be here.